दैट इज एक्चुअली सिल्क, क्वीन ऑफ द टेक्सटाइल्स. ओके, पोचमपल्ली सिल्क. नेक्स्ट अदर डिफरेंट. ओके, हियर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द सिल्क इन लास्ट क्लास. दिस इज वन एनिमल फाइबर. नाउ एन अदर एनिमल फाइबर दैट इज वूल. दैट इज वूल. ओके, लेट अस स्टडी अबाउट स्टोरी ऑफ वूल. एक्चुअली लाइक सिल्क, वूल इज ऑल्सो वन टाइप ऑफ एनिमल फाइबर. इट इज एक्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम द एनिमल. सिल्क इज ऑल्सो एक्सट्रैक्टेड फॉर एनिमल्स. ओके, हियर वूल इज ऑल्सो एक्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम वन टाइप ऑफ एनिमल्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, यूजुअली वूल इज एक्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम द फर ऑफ द फर एंड fleece, fur and fleece of animals. From this fleece and fur, wool is extracted. Wool fiber is extracted. Understanding? Observe carefully. Usually, fur and fleece are collected from different types of animals. Usually they are collected from the sheep. They are collected from sheep. Next to goat, usually. Okay, yak. Next to camel. Okay, like these different words. Llama. Okay, like other different types of organism, from different types of organisms. Usually these fleece and fur are collected. Okay, usually when we observe the all wool, okay, observe carefully, when we observe the wool, okay, means entire story of the, when we observe the entire story of the wool or quality of the wool, merino sheep, they produce very very valuable wool. Understanding? Merino sheep, they produce very very valuable wool. Understanding? Actually they can produce the 3 to 18 kg of wool for year. Understanding? Very very valuable one. And here soft one, soft and very very valuable wool it is. Understanding? From different types of animals, from different types of animals we can extract the wool. We can extract the wool. Understanding? Listen carefully. Okay, next. Thank you. extraction of wool. When we observe the extraction of wool, there are different types of steps. Okay, what are they? They are different. First one, shearing. First one process, shearing. What is shearing? Listen carefully here. What is shearing? Shearing means it is one type of process in which fleece from animals, fleece is removed. Fleece is removed. Means directly you can say collection of fleece from animals. This is called usually shearing process. Observe carefully. Observe collection of fleece from the animal. Okay, this is called usually shearing process. Here, during this shearing process, first grease is applied on skin of the animal. Why usually those farmers apply grease on skin of the animals? Why? To prevent the damage on skin. To protect the skin from any injuries. Listen carefully here. Why? Why means to protect skin, to protect the skin from injuries. Usually grease is applied on skin of the animals. Then before removing or collecting the fleece from the animal, usually fleece or entire animal is washed with water thoroughly. Understanding? Usually they wash the fleece with water thoroughly. Okay, Then, usually, fleece is washed with water thoroughly. After washing for allows to drying process. Usually this fleece is allowed to drying or dry. Understanding? After drying, then people or farmers cut the fur or fleece. Listen carefully. Cut the fur or fleece by using the scissors. These are called usually shearers. Okay, usually shearers. By using scissors or shearers. Okay, usually listen carefully here. Shears. Fleece or fur is removed from the body of the animals. Okay, by using the scissors. They are also called as shears. Nowadays, shearing machines are available. Understanding? Nowadays, shearing machines are available. Usually, when we cut the fur by using machines, fur is in uniform condition, in uniform nature. By cutting the scissors, we cannot get the uniform fur. Understanding? But by using the machines, we can get the uniform fleece and entire complete fur or complete fleece is removed from the animal's body by using the machines. But when we use the scissors, we cannot separate or we cannot cut the entire complete fur or fleece from the animal's body. That is why using machines is a good practice to get the good quality and good sized wool or good sized fleece. Are understanding? Observe carefully all important ones. See, observe carefully. Next, which is the suitable or good season to collect the fleece? Actually, sheep or any other animals, they require the fleece or fur, to protect themselves from cool conditions, means winter season. Actually, shearers collect the fleece after winter season, means during the spring season. During the spring season, shearers collect the fleece or fur from the animal's body. Understanding? Because after spring, actually summer will come. You know very well that. Here, after spring, summer comes. Then after summer, you know very well that after summer, actually monsoon season, okay, means autumn season, okay, after autumn season, usually winter season, means when we collect the fleece in spring season. Listen carefully here. Spring season. Then what will happen? Fleece will grow on the skin of the animals. Listen carefully here. Skin of the animals. Okay. For next two seasons. Understanding? Up to the, for example, winter season, spring season, next summer season, next autumn season, next winter season. Understanding? Means before they are entering into the winter season, they can get the full fleece. Means complete fleece on their bodies. They can develop. Because there is much time. There is very long period. Spring season, next summer season, autumn season. Like this, there is a long period. In this long period, they can develop the fleece completely. Before entering into the winter season, they can develop entire or complete fleece or fur on their body. Are understanding? This is very important. Remember. Okay, that is why this is the suitable period or suitable season to collect the or to perform the shearing process. Okay, this is very, very important. Remember. During the summer season, there is no need of fur. Actually, organisms which are grown in or which are growing in very cool conditions. Okay, Himachal Pradesh. Okay, next to other different Haryana, Punjab, Jammu and Kashmir. Okay, Delhi, next to Uttar Pradesh, like this. In this type of states, very cool conditions are present during the winter season. In such conditions, animals require fur. In summer season, in autumn season, understanding, in spring season, this type of animals do not require the fur. That is why immediately after this winter season, actually shearers perform the shearing process. Okay, observe carefully. Next. Next. Scouring process or washing. What? Scouring process or washing. After shearing. Now we have fur or fleece. Okay. Now you have to perform the scouring process or washing. In this process, actually collected fleece is washed cleanly or washed thoroughly by using water. Means after collecting the fleece from the animal, then we have to place the or we have to pour the all fleece in water. Understanding? Listen carefully here. In water. Why? Why should we perform this process? Or why should we perform this step? Why should we perform? Why me? Actually, already we discussed grease. Grease is applied on the skin of the animals to protect its skin from the injuries. Now this grease, listen carefully, why we are applying the grease to skin? Actually, in the time, all fur it is also applied by the grease. Are understanding? Observe carefully here. Means some grease or some amount of grease is attached on the fleece or fur. Now we have to remove the, listen carefully here. Now we have to remove the this grease and other dust particles and other dirty particles, okay, and other unwanted particles. What? Unwanted particles. Listen carefully here. We should use the scouring process. Here some chemicals are added to the water. Okay, means which type of chemicals? Chemicals which can remove the grease, dust, dirty particles and other unwanted particles from the fur. Dirt type of chemicals are used in the water. Understanding? Then we have to place the all collected fur in that water, chemical water. Okay, now you have to keep all fur or fleece in water containing the chemicals for some time. Are understanding? observe carefully. Okay, then you have to remove the fleece from the, you have to remove the fleece from the water. Understanding, observe carefully, important points. Observe all important points. Okay, this is washing. After washing, listen carefully. After washing, here we have to listen carefully here. Cool A. After washing, cool A is passed on to the fleece. Understanding? Passed on to the fleece. Why? Why this type of process is conducted here? Why cool air is applied on the fleece? Why me? When we apply the cool air on the fleece, fleece become softened. Fleece become very soft. Okay, are softened. Okay, are soft. To make the fleece soft, to make the fleece soft, after washing, we have to supply the cool air. We have to supply cool air. This is a very important process. Second process. What is that? Scouring or washing process. Understanding? Next, third one, sorting or wool classing or fleece classing or fur classing. What? Sorting means classification. Okay, classify. After scouring process, here fleece particles or fur, they are sorting. They are sorting. Listen, based on their length, based on their lengths, and based on their length means short ones, long ones like this, and other twigs of the plants and small particles of the plants are small twigs. Okay, are small stalk-like structures. Stalks of the plants. Stalks of the plants. They are also separated. These are also separated during the sorting process. Understanding? Observe carefully. Observe once. Observe carefully. Sorting means classification of wool. Okay, in this process, actually, based on their lengths, means long ones, short ones, soft ones, rough ones. Understanding this type of fleece or this type of fur are separated. Then if there are any twigs or any stalks or any leaves of the plants, they are also separated. They are also separated from the fleece. Means fleece is classified based on the length and based on their nature, soft one, hard one, like this. Understanding? Observe carefully. This is very important one here. This is sorting process or wool closing. Wool closing process. Next process is bleaching process. Okay, next process is bleaching process. What is bleaching? What is bleaching process? Calcium hypochloride, important chemical. Calcium hypochloride. This is a very important chemical. After sorting process, fleece is dipped in calcium hypochloride. Dipped in calcium hypochloride. Observe clearly. What? Okay, what? Calcium hypochloride. What is the use of this calcium hypochloride? In this process, actually, what will in this process? Wool. Or fleece. It is dipped in this chemical. Why? Why means to bleach or to wash the fur or fleece. When we wash the fleece or fur in by using the calcium hypochloride water, entire fur or color of the fur or color of the fleece becomes white color. Means after this process we can get the white color fleece. We can get the white color fleece. This is very important. White color fleece after this process. In this process we mix the calcium hypochloride in water, then we add the entire sorting fur or fleece in this water containing calcium hypochlorite. After some time we can get the white color fleece or fur. This is the bleaching process. This is bleaching. Okay, after bleaching process, okay, after bleaching, after some time we have to collect the fur from the calcium hypochlorite medium. Then we have to, listen carefully here, we have to dry it. We have to dry it. Next, observe important points. Observe carefully. Bleaching process. Then next one, dyeing process. Understanding? Next, fifth one is dyeing process. Okay, what is dyeing? You know, dyeing. Dyes. Different types of colors. These are different types of colors. After bleaching process, we have to, or after bleaching process, fleece is, listen carefully here, fleece is dipped in different types of tubs containing different colors. Understanding? Here, based on the color, if we want to red color wool, then we have to dip the entire fur in tub containing the red color dye. Understanding? Like this, in different types of tubs, different types of dyes are present. After bleaching process, we have to listen carefully here, dip the fur in tubs containing the dyes. Okay, when we dip the fur in tubs containing colors or dyes, we can get the colored or dyed fiber, dyed these pieces or fur. Understanding? Observe carefully. Okay, this is very important one here. Dyeing process. After dyeing process, that dyed wool or dyed fleece or dyed fur is dried for some time. This is important, a simple one. Okay, that is your dyeing process. Okay, next to combing process. Next one, combing. What is combing? In this process, actually, dyed fleece. What? Dyed fleece. This place is cleared. Clear by using the some combing machines or combing instruments. These instruments contain teeth-like structures, means many teeth. Many teeth. By using this teeth, all fleas are all fur. They are cleared. They are cleared. Okay. This is a simple process, combing process. Next, spinning process. Next process is spinning. What is spinning? Spinning process means it is very, very important process in entire this extraction of the wool. Process in which small wool fibers, isn't it clear? Small wool fibers are spinned, or they are wound and formed. Isn't it clear? Many small these wool fibers, they are spinned and form yarn, or thread, wool thread or wool yarn. Because of this spinning process, we can get the wool yarn. There are different types of spinning machines. Spinning machines. By using the spinning machines, we can make the yarn from the small wool fibers. Small wool fibers. Here, after bleaching process, we can get the small wool yarn, wool fibers. Those small wool fibers, they are dyed and they are formed ultimately. Okay, by the spinning process, all small wool fibers are combined and form yarn, wool yarn. Understanding? Wool yarn is formed here, very important, remember. Observe carefully. Observe clearly. Next, after spinning process, knitting process. In here, by using these small needles. By using these small needles, a single Yarn, listen carefully here, is used in these needles. Actually, in knitting process, needles are used. In these needles, a long single yarn is used. By using the needles, having the a single long yarn or long thread. Usually woolen fabrics are knitted. Woolen fabrics are knitted. Listen carefully here. Different types of woolen fabrics. For example, caps, okay, or hats. Next, saris. Understanding. And different types of woolen fabrics are knitted by this knitting process. Understanding. Different types of woolen cloths are knitted by using this knitting process. Understanding. Next process, weaving process. Next one is weaving. During the weaving process, usually yarn, woolen fabrics are weaved on the hand looms or power looms. Nowadays, maximum power looms are used to weave the woolen fabrics. Okay, woolen fabrics. 30 years, 40 years back, actually hand looms were extensively used. But nowadays, power looms are using extensively to weave the woolen fabrics by using the woolen yarn. Understanding. Different types of sweaters, okay, jacket, caps, next to gloves. Understanding. And other different types of woolen cloth or woolen fabric are weaved by this process. Understanding? Observe carefully.